there are con artists in every profession. Unfortunately, in property, there's a lot of money involved. You know, I can do a deal and make 100 grand, which, you know, most people would take 4 or 5 years to make that. When there's that level of money involved, there's a level to which corruption, you know, becomes a problem. But also there's a level to which, and it's a bit like we were saying earlier about naivety, people want to believe that it's going to happen. So they just do dumb shit. It's not even, you kind of, I look at them and I go, well, what did you think was going to happen?
Example?
Well, so a more legitimate scheme would be something like the student houses that they will send out adverts for 10% guaranteed rent for student housing. Just buy in, it'll be fine, 10% guaranteed rent. As soon as you ask that company, well, what happens if the company goes bust? Where's my guarantee? They won't even reply to the email. You know, and that's how I would stop it. But most people won't ask that question. They'll just go, oh, that sounds amazing. Let's go. There have been companies. My dad was involved in one of them. The guys are all in prison now, where he was effectively what they call an armchair investor. And again, I wouldn't recommend anyone does that because you don't know who you're giving your money to. But they basically sell deals, you know, source houses, sell deals, tell you that they'll do everything for you. Say, you just give us the money, you sit back, don't worry about it, the rent will come in. It's just nonsense. You know, these guys, basically, there were tenants involved. So again, this is horrendous playing with people's lives. So you've got the investors who basically get ripped off. The people that are tenants are genuinely paying the rent and the middleman company doesn't pass on the rent to the landlord. The tenant ends up getting evicted or losing the home because the house might get repossessed. I mean, it's just a complete mess. And the people who did the deal in the first place, they just walk away. Now, in this instance, they didn't. They all went to prison. But there's some pretty big stuff going on. And then you've got the smaller one-man band sources. I've dealt with one and managed to see the deals through. But he was basically doing a similar thing. You know, he was kind of, I think he got himself to a point where he didn't have enough money. So he kept doing deals and taking money from this deal to pay that deal. And it just, you know, it all came unstuck. And again, it's just trickery. And it's crazy when you can make money in property properly.